Look what Obama's Muslims in Homeland Security can do to flights midair and aren't done yet. Do Muslim terrorists have currently possessed the technology to hack into our airplanes and take them down mid-flight? What we just learned from a high-ranking Homeland Security official will give you nightmares for weeks and months to come when you consider who was in charge of Homeland Security under Barack Hussein Obama. Barack Hussein Obama did irrefutable damage as president, where he worked tirelessly to further the cause of Islam while taking a sledgehammer to our country and our Constitution, and I might add to Christians. One of Obama's tactics was to put Muslims into high-level positions throughout our government. That's what the overtaking of the government is, the caliphate that they are talking about. Where he put an ISIS-supporting Muslim terrorist by the name of Mohammed El-Bieri in charge of Homeland Security back in 2014, while El-Bieri was removed a short time later due to massive outrage on behalf of Americans, we will forever wonder what top-level government secrets El-Bieri took with him on his way out the door. A very good question. As determined as President Trump is in his resolve to make our country great again, Obama's Muslim spies keep managing to worm their way into the White House. Back in May, shocking information emerged about Trump's Deputy National Security Advisor, Dina Habib Powell, who was discovered to not only be a Muslim, but good buddies with both Hillary and Obama, former Iranian Muslim Brotherhood advisor Valerie Jarrett as well. Another Obama operative appears to have recently breached Homeland Security in recent months after we learned that the person set to take over head of Homeland Security, Kirstjen Nielsen, is not only a Muslim lover, but has expressed her goal to flood Europe with Muslim refugees, leaving one wonder what this woman's intentions for our country is. Let us not forget about Obama's spy ring that was busted up over the summer after it was discovered the Muslim Brotherhood, Abid Imran and Jamal Awan, got positions as IT workers for Congress, where these Muslim Brotherhood-linked individuals were taking intelligence off Congress's laptops and putting the info on an external server, of course. The Muslims were paid well for our secrets, where our country's most highly guarded intelligence documents are now possibly in the hands of America's biggest enemies. With Obama's shadow government now appearing to be in full swing with his little Muslim spies infiltrating every facet of our government, what Homeland Security agents are now able to do is downright chilling. Keep in mind that Obama's Muslims could very well possess this same capability and technology after managing to worm their way into Homeland Security while he was in office, and even recently, even under President Trump. Homeland Security investigator Robert Hickey revealed during a speech at CyberSat Summit in Virginia this past week that he was able to successfully take over full control of a plane that was on the runway after his team used radio communication to hack the craft. This could pose a major threat to airlines, although Boeing officials are trying desperately to downplay the cybersecurity breach as not a big deal. A government official revealed that he and his team of IT experts remotely hacked into a Boeing 757 as it sat on the runway and were able to take control of its flight functions, the Sun UK reported. We got the airplane on September 19, 2016, Hickey stated. 2 days later, I was successful in accomplishing a remote, non-cooperative penetration, which means I didn't have anybody touching the airplane, I would say. Why did they write it this way? I didn't have an insider threat. What's chilling is that the devices that Hickey used to hack the aircraft were things that you could easily get through airport security. I stood off using typical stuff that could get through security, and we were able to establish a presence on the system of the aircraft. Hickey went on saying that he and his team used a combination of radio frequency communication to hack into the craft, although the details of the security breach remain classified. Let's all hope the only people who possess the knowledge to hack into a plane and take it over are only people with America's best interest in mind, and not Muslims who keep managing to get jobs in Homeland Security, which has chillingly already happened several times. Yes, it is frightening, and it's very disturbing, to say the least. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below, and again, thank you so much for watching.